In order for us to fully reap the benefits of development, we have to exist in the darkness. So for anyone who feels like they're at a time of being swallowed by darkness in their life, being hidden in plain sight, or just being completely buried, I'm here to bring you a shift in perspective. Not to change the reality of your circumstances, because I'm no magician, right? But to allow you to see your place in the center of all of your circumstances with a fresh set of eyes and a new perspective so that you have more clarity to move forward. Welcome to the Ron Hap Podcast, where we get real and then some. I'm your host, Jasmin Siri, and every week I will speak on topics that align with reprogramming the subconscious mind. I share my experiences and discuss how I navigate life consciously so we can reach higher heights and deeper dimensions of the mind to reach our goals from a healed and open place together. So, let's get started. I want you to consider this dark place being a burial for your old beliefs. When I'm in dark spaces of my life, I have to remain realistic about this part of the life experience, that there will always be more times like this. And when we find ourselves in dark spaces, though some scenarios may feel new, with new levels of pain depending on what's in front of us at the time, but there's always just this small voice in the back of our minds that says, damn, I've been here before. I'm experiencing it again. I know this dark place. And we are familiar with how our bodies handle disappointment, discomfort, pain. And instead of doing the hard thing, which is moving it out of our bodies with different healing modalities, sometimes we judge ourselves for it instead, not because it was or was not our fault, but genuinely because we are the closest souls to blame for the things that go wrong. This is a part of the self-hate practice that our bodies and minds go to war with every time, so much to a point where we grow sick and we become depressed and dysregulate our own nervous system because we take life's happenings as a form of self-betrayal. And if we are not intentional about how we spend our time, we could get stuck there. Understand that there are scenarios that we can't save ourselves from, but we will always have the power and ability to nurture ourselves through. We love to think of what we should have done or how we could have moved, what we did or did not say, as if a more creative delivery is the key to unlock a portal that could bring us back to that place to make a different decision. So if you are in a position in your life that feels like you're being buried, be buried and accept that this is where you are. If I'm being honest, every eyesore of my past, every past scenario that leaves me trembling in embarrassment, represents a version of myself that I needed to lay to rest. I would not have gotten to this realization had I not experienced the times that challenged me and shattered my ego, threatened the false identity I tried to build out of something that was not stable or sustainable. I thought having community or a large network made me valuable or in my power until I saw those people were full of shit and not reliable. I thought my family was all I needed until I saw they couldn't support me beyond their own traumas. I thought a career would save me until one lie from a jealous spirit tarnished my reputation in an industry I served almost a decade. I thought being chosen by a man would heal me, but all it has done is shown me the cracks in my self-esteem that keep me from choosing myself. And in this emptiness, in this dark space that feels alone, I'm somehow surrounded by a God that gives me love and grace and fills me completely. And I swallow it, and I'm buried, and then I'm reborn. We are seeds, and we need the darkness of the soil and the nutrients inside the manure and the rain and the sunshine and all of those things. I have this little inside joke with myself. Because my name is Jasmine and Jasmine is a flower, it feels like the more bullshit that life throws at me, and it really can lay it on thick, The more this happens, the more fragrant and radiant and beautiful I begin to blossom, and my life just becomes. And I think humans are God's flowers, you know, no matter what your beliefs, even if your beliefs are differing from mine, we have to come from someplace, right? So I want you to consider this the next time you feel like you're knee deep in the bullshit and it feels like it's towering over you. I want you to ask yourself, how will this bullshit nurture the soil of my character so that I can fully exist and be present in the future that I'm called to have? Another special thing about being consumed by darkness is that we have the luxury of doing our intentional work in private. No one has to know all of the hard things or ways we are changing cycles. We can disappear and pop back up completely different. And one of the most beautiful things about my channel and podcast is that it's a hidden gem. It feels like a little secret society that's real and untainted. To some people, it's like I just popped out of the sky, and it was like I remember so many eras of myself that were lost, that no one knew about. It's not that I cringe about it. It's just that directionless version of myself was always in everyone's face, was always going out, was always seen, was always, you know, in the middle of something. And this version of me, it just seems really chill. It's just this channel is so important to me is because all you have is me, spirit, and yourself. And I get to be that vehicle that allows you the space for you and the divine to have a real conversation. You know, if I look back at all of my old journals, I realize that this is the job that I ask God to have. And the work we do here, to be honest, it may not be for everybody, but for who it's for, it's really transformative and it's comforting, and I take so much pride in being that for you, being what I wish I had in my time of development and being the catalyst for a breakthrough. If this podcast and YouTube channel has helped you out in any way, please do not forget to like, comment, subscribe, leave a review. It helps me out so much. Thank you all so much for being a part of my journey, being a part of me, and really being my angels. This is a dream come true. Now let's get back to the episode. So take full advantage of the allure and come back completely new. You know, we are at the precipice of a new year. And in 2025, that is the year of 9. And in numerology, 9 represents the ending of a cycle, the fulfillment of one cycle, and the emergence of something new. Number 9 is considered a significant and powerful number that symbolizes completion and the start of a new phase. In the cycle, some people may experience transformation that can bring about a significant change and improvement in different areas of your life. It represents healing. You know, unhappy memories may arise so that we are able to make a change so that it could be healed. This era is all about tying up loose ends. This year can be a time of completing tasks, doing all of things or starting all of the things that you said you always wanted to, and allowing it to take you on a journey. It says that the number 9 is also your heart's desire number or your soul urge number. It reveals your innermost passion and yearning, the unconscious emotional powerhouse that drives your decision making. It's the behaviors that you have that you're not even aware of that leads you to your destiny. So if you think deeply and philosophically and want to know the underlining themes of your life and you take pride in your reflections and you align yourself with your purpose as much as you can, you know, this is a very interesting year for you in 2025. This is where your soul urge comes down to really making a change and being in a purpose that not only makes your dreams come true, but it could potentially serve others, like guiding and healing and teaching and protecting, supporting other people. If those things make you happiest and you feel like you're at the edge of jumping off into this destiny, 2025 is the year that you do it and you don't look back. If you are naturally drawn towards spirituality, or you seek a higher level of consciousness and you like to make sense of the chaos of this world, if you're compassionate, if you have a giving nature, if you have a spiritual outlook on life, this may be the year, 2025, that it all comes together. And this is what I felt for myself. This is what it says online. And I'm super excited about it. I feel like 2025 is going to be just an amazing year for a lot of people that are in alignment with the things that kind of are on the edge of spirituality, holistic, nurturing, wellness, you know, all of the things. I want you to allow all of the moments in your memory card that had you feeling moments of doubt, scenarios that have humbled you and have shifted your character, sit with them and make peace with the fact that this way of being will be left in the soil. This is a time for you to make amends with the layers that you've stripped for this more polished version of yourself. And when we do that, we're better able to service others, to show that we don't have to be perfect to take a step forward, but to be polished means to use the substance of all of the shitty things in our past as a buffer for a more confident, clear, and grounded version of you. And I think that's all you need in the next year. Be grounded. Have a vision. Have clarity. Know what your intentions are in the beginning of the year. And see where it takes you. Because in a world where controversy and drama and all of these humbling experiences are put on display for other people's enjoyment as a way of escaping their own bullshit, when we choose to walk in our life as a representation of all of the old cycles that we've left behind, we do it as a way to lead in this shift of consciousness. You know, I believe that the future will call for more leaders that are in authenticity and in truth. So I suggest remaining open to your dark truth, because honestly, everyone has one. And be fully open to the fact that, yeah, this X, Y, and Z was my past, but this is my future. This is my why. And no matter what, because I've spent my own time in the dark developing room of my life to deal with the cards and the decisions that didn't result in my highest good, I've learned from my own experiences. And because of the discernment and knowledge gained, I walk in my life like I've gained from the darkness. And when you do that, you show others that they can gain from their darkness too. Have patience. It's easier said than done, especially in the middle of this dark place. And photographers know this as well, that in order to allow light-sensitive materials to process, they have to develop in the dark and in the right amount of time. And I believe God knows that about us as well. Sometimes we never know how our stories will develop to be of service to the people we're meant to help until it has. So understand that our dark rooms of our life are designed for our best outcome. And that's the beauty of not knowing and surrendering. Sometimes we force this urge to be seen so much that we reach the surface before it's our time truly to be in the sun. And when this happens, it also shows an underdeveloped version of us, or a flaw in our character, that if we truly sat down long enough and accepted being buried, we would have learned from that experience without the consequence of damaging other people in the process, or without giving ammo to our opposing forces. I guess when a person is developing their own character in their own darkness, they do it so that they're equipped with a foundation strong enough to see past other people's darkness. So when it's time to handle those said people, we can handle them in a way that thrusts them towards their awareness instead of punishing them, so that they can move on as well. And I think that's the gift of being aware. That's the gift of really truly understanding and having grace for ourselves just as much as we have for other people. But when there are parts within ourselves that we choose to rush through or brush past just to get this outcome, we just end up growing through someone else's experiences of the same thing that troubles us. So you see, you know, we never escape the work. So choose wisely. Your darkness now or someone else's later, either way, you're going to persevere, right? Why risk the possibility of losing everything you've built for the foresight that you can gain in the here and now to better be of service for whoever is in your community and around you that needs you? I say all of this to say, you know, the dark place is not a bad thing. You know, we were formed in darkness. We were created and developed in darkness. I feel like God sometimes exists in the dark spaces. It's not always light and fluffy. Even when I close my eyes and I have these creative ideas, it exists in the nothingness, in this pit of black that I'm able to be everything and anything that I want to be. When I started to see my darkness as just a playground for all versions of myself to exist, a playground for me to live out different outcomes and give myself an opportunity to forgive myself or give myself an opportunity to be angry and act on how I feel when there is no place around me to do that. I see the darkness as a tool. And I want you to see it as that too. You will have your time in the sun. There's going to be a time where you won't be able to do half of the things that you're able to do now because your life is going to expand in such a way that there just will be no time to, and it'll be a blessing. But you're going to miss that dark time, this special moment that you have with yourself where you're able to fully get to know you 100%. Why would you waste that opportunity on entertaining yourself with a relationship or entertaining yourself with drugs or video games or just scrolling? All of these things that in a couple of years, you don't know how long it'll be here. I had to think about that because I love to doom scroll. Like, that's my addiction. And I had to stop and realize who I was. I'm like, wait a minute. I have so much inside of my mind that I need to get out. I continue to doom scroll because the weight of everything in my mind is so overwhelming. There's so many things that I want to do that I feel like I can't touch. And so to escape my mind, I decide to scroll. And the things that are existing in my mind that I have to get out into the world, it's never going to go away. So I either pretend to be haunted by it and try to escape from it, or I use it to bring it into the future, to be the change that this world needs to see. Food for thought. I think that is all that I have. I have yapped enough. I think that is all that I have for today. Thank you so much for making it to this far into the video. Do not forget to like, comment, and subscribe. And follow me on Instagram @jasmin.siri. And I will see you guys in my next one.